The Michael Sam announcement does raise plenty of questions about how the NFL, its players, and Sam himself will deal with all this. We explore that with Wade Davis, a former NFL player who came out as gay after he retired. He's executive director of the You Can Play Project, an advocacy group working for equality for LGBT athletes in sports. He spoke with Sam before his announcement. And Kevin Blackistone, he's a panelist for ESPN. He teaches sports journalism at the University of Maryland. We welcome both of you. Wade Davis, to you first. You did talk with Michael Sam. Help us. Do you know why he chose to do this right now?
You know, one of the big things that Michael wanted to do was give executives, teams time to really evaluate Wade him as a player, and also have those hard conversations about what would it mean to draft a gay player. He wasn't trying to hide anything. He also believes that what team wouldn't want a player with the courage and strength that he's exhibited? I think that that all teams want players who exhibit great leadership and great courage, and that's all that Michael has done.
How important a move do you think this is?
I think to a lot of people it's an important move, and to Michael it was something that he understood the gravity of it, but he wasn't overwhelmed by it.
What do you mean?
That he understood that this was a big deal as far as being the first openly gay NFL player. But to him, he was just doing something he's always done. Fight through adversity, show up with a courageous heart, and be himself.
Kevin Blackistone, how do you weigh the significance of this announcement?
I think it's very significant. I think it's more significant for the NFL than it is for Michael Sam. A lot of people have asked, you know, about the hurdles that he's going to have to overcome when he gets in the league, but he has said he's very comfortable with who he is. He's a college graduate, he's black, and the third thing is he's gay, as if we need to know his sexual orientation. He was voted the MVP on his team by his teammates. He was one of the best football players in the SEC this past year. It's the NFL, which has been homophobic for so long, one of the strongest bastions of homophobia in our society, that's going to have to deal with this. The executives who are going to have to decide whether to bring him into their franchise, coaches who are going to have to decide how to fit him into the fabric of the team, and teammates who are going to have to decide how to embrace him. Those are the real hurdles in this situation.
Well, let's explore that for just a moment. What do you expect is going to mean? What happens now? The draft, as we said, is not until May. It's
right.
Several months off. What happens at this point? Do the owners who may be interested in him?
Well, the first thing that's going to happen is he's going to be the center of attention at the NFL Combine in April, which is when all the draft-eligible players hoping to get into the NFL show up and work out for all the scouts and the coaches.
Literally work out.
Exactly. Now it's a televised event. So this is going to be the most anticipated NFL combine in the history of the NFL. After he gets through that, will come the draft. And everybody will wait to see whether or not his situation and what he said about his personal life impacts what the rest of the league and the teams and the coaches and executives think about them. Already today, not more than 24 hours into this story, we've already heard rumors about this guy, Michael Sam, the SEC Defensive Player of the Year, by far the best college football conference in the country, that his draft status has started to slip simply because of this announcement.
Wade Davis, do you think that's the case, that his draft status, I know it's speculation, but what is your sense of that?
I would disagree with Michael a little bit. I think that, I'm sorry, Kevin. I think that we make these broad assumptions that the NFL is a homophobic place. But what I've experienced since I've come out and the work that I've been allowed to do with the NFL has been great. You know, I think that what happens is that we don't see players who are out, and we make this broad assumption that they must be out because this place is homophobic. But players weren't out in college. Players weren't out in high school. So that speaks more about what our country needs to do as a whole more than it does what's wrong with the NFL. You know, and I'm also a person that knows that players in the NFL have to deal with players of different races, different classes, different religions, and they make it work. And it's not cotton candy and lollipops, right? But it is a time where players have friction, and they can make fun of each other. They protect each other from everyone else. And I think that Sam's has proven that by playing in the SEC in one of the toughest conferences, that his teammates accepted him. And these are the same players who will be playing on Sunday. So I think that we have to give athletes a lot more credit and say, hey, some of them may be homophobic, but a lot of them have gay brothers, gay sisters, gay cousins, and have experienced playing with someone who's gay.
Kevin Blackstone, do you think attitudes could be changing?
Well, I think Wade touches on something here. I was talking to a friend of mine who has a lot to do with the league and is a former player, and he pointed out that, the league is a very young league, and it's been getting younger year after year after year, and that there are a lot more players now who have played with gay players, maybe in high school, certainly have gay friends that they know from high school and college, that sort of thing. And so maybe they are a little bit more tolerant than their predecessors. Having said that, I still believe that the NFL has been and is a homophobic operation, given the fact that the only people we know of who have been gay and played in the league are people who have come out afterwards to say that they survived that environment. So hopefully Michael Sam can change that environment.
Wade Davis, is Michael Sam prepared, again, based on your talking with him, what is he prepared to face in the months to come?
Well, first of all, he doesn't think he's going to face anything that he didn't already face in college. You know, I would say probably 20-30% of the NFL is made up of guys who played in the SEC. So it's not like he came from this small school, right? And he also was the captain of his team, so he knows what it's like to be a leader. He knows what it's like to deal with adversity. He's also understanding that it's also his responsibility to protect his teammates, that there's going to be a player or two that may say something homophobic, but he's not going to run to the principal or to the media and say, hey, this guy said this and this guy said that. These are going to be his brothers. He's going to earn their trust by his play off the field and showing up as other players do off the field.
All right, we are going to have to leave it there. It's a subject I know we're going to spend more time on. But tonight, Wade Davis, we thank you. Kevin Blackstone.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.